welcome to the newest episode of SOURCECAST. Today we have myself, Rory, who's going to be hosting the podcast today, and I'm joined along with Michelle McGrenaghan. Michelle is the newest member of the Source team. She's been working with us now for a couple of months post-lockdown. So Michelle, you're very welcome to today's episode. How are you feeling about it?
Yeah, okay. A wee bit nervous, but yeah, okay. It's the first time I've ever done anything like this.
I just asked that, like, we weren't chatting there for 10 minutes and you were telling me how you were feeling anyway. But so a wee introduction, Michelle. Aaron Grugan calls it the onset. Just a couple of basic questions for the listeners to get to know more about you. So the first one is, please state your full name.
Michelle Sheila Doyle, or Sheila McGrenaghan. Oh God, I was going to say Doyle there.
You were going to say Doyle. You forgot you were married.
Married this past 5 years, like, but kind of forgot that.
Michelle Sheila McGrenaghan.
Yeah.
Lovely. Where did Sheila come out of?
That's my mommy's name. So I wonder if my Aaron's going to be able to take the mick out of me now about that.
Very good. Did you know Rachel Gray's name is Rachel Patricia?
Only into this podcast.
It isn't actually, but we just call her Rachel Patricia for some reason.
Oh, right, okay.
So the next one then, Michelle, is where were we born?
So I was born in Oma, but I was quite premature when I was born. So I was moved then to Derry Hospital and I was put in life support for 2 weeks. So it was all a wee bit of a dodgy start, but as you can see, I'm not. I haven't feeled too much from it or anything.
There you go. Hey, if you might not have been with us if things had went badly, but thank God you're here and you're with us. That's good. I didn't know that about you. So there you go. You learn something new every day. Where did you grow up then, Michelle? Because I know you're living in Fintan now, the Bar Church. Where did you grow up?
Yeah, I'm only a below into Fintan. So I lived in Trullick. And yeah, I'm a Trullick woman at heart, not really a Fintan woman.
And is Doyle a famous name in Trullick, is it? Is it popular?
No, probably not, no. I have five older brothers, so they might have tarnished the name a wee bit. So no, it's not really that famous.
It's mainly like Donnelly's and stuff, isn't it?
Yeah. No, we're not a big footballer family.
Not a big footballing family. Good stuff. The next one then. So what's your favourite hobby or pastime? And this doesn't have to be fitness related. This can be anything at all.
Okay. I suppose non-fitness related, I just like to socialise. I like going to people's houses, going for coffee, going just, you know, generally being around people. Not necessarily a hobby. Other than that, just kind of socialising and getting out and when possible.
Good stuff. And that's why I think you're perfect for the role of coffee morning host. Because you do have that. You're great in social environments. You're really easy to talk to. So for the listeners who don't know, Michelle hosts our coffee morning. We started the coffee morning since lockdown. Just giving the members an opportunity just to get together and chat over Zoom. And Michelle has been hosting that every Tuesday and Thursday. How are you finding that, Michelle? Are you finding that good, that wee role?
Yeah, I'm really enjoying it. And I'd really recommend, like, even after lockdown, for people that do, like, coffee morning stuff for charity, do it virtual because you don't even need to clean your house.
Yeah, that's a good bit. You don't have to bake any goods or you don't have to clean your house.
You just have to clean the square that's around your camera.
Exactly. Good stuff. So the next one then, this is a question that has been asked in the previous podcast. It's an interesting question. So what's your favourite sound, Michelle?
Well, when this question was first asked to you, I was like, what is my favourite sound? I had no idea. I was like, no idea. But I really thought hard about it. And I think maybe only maybe mummies or daddies will get this. But when everybody is in bed and the house is in silence, and like, you know, you should be going to bed too to get your, you know, your 8 hours sleep or whatever. But I just sit in the kitchen in silence and know everybody's in bed and it's great.
So your favorite sound is actually an oxymoron then. It's actually the sound of silence.
Yeah, that is it. Exactly.
It's still so after a stressful day of looking after the kids, you just enjoy that wee break, that wee minute of silence to yourself.
I'm hoping people will be able to, like, you know what I mean there, but yeah.
I'm sure a lot of parents will relate to that one, especially with young children. And you have two as well. So we'll just touch on that. So Molly and Cormac, what age are they now?
So Cormac's 2 and Molly's 7 months.
Right.
So
and what age were you when you had Cormac then?
Cormac, well, what am I now? I'm 29 in September, so 27.
You were actually the same age as me then when you had Cormac.
Yeah, there you go, Ray. You need to get a move on.
Time for me to grow up a wee bit, you think?
No, time enough. Don't panic.
So the next wee bit then, Michelle, I'm not sure many of the members will know this, but you actually have a role in childcare. So my first question is, how did it come about you starting to work in childcare? Is it something that you studied, or how did you come about working in that environment?
I always loved working with kids, like literally from a really young age. I would always been babysitting, helping out, whatever the case may be. So I just loved working with kids. It was always something I was passionate about and wanted to do. So then I went to college in Belfast and studied and did a little bit of partying with Fiona McGrenaghan as well. So I did my early childhood studies degree, and then I came out and worked in a playgroup for a few years. And now this last 5.5 years, I'm in a daycare in Oma and manager there at the minute. So it's great. It's really busy. I love working, being the manager role. It's lovely working with people, the parents, the staff, the kids, everything. So it's busy, but it's really rewarding too.
Yeah, definitely. Just out of curiosity then, is that how you met Paul, through Fiona, partying with Fiona?
No, I knew Paul long before I knew Fiona.
Right. So for the listeners who don't know, Fiona is a member of Source as well. She's actually Michelle's sister-in-law. Michelle and Fiona are two of the best trainers in the gym. So speaking of training, the next wee bit then is just about your fitness journey. So before we talk about how you became the start working in Source, we'll just talk about how you began in fitness. So just let us know how your fitness journey began, whereabouts, how did it start?
Started a long time ago. This is funny, I was quite an overweight child and teenager and stuff, so I decided to join a gym thinking that I was going to be skinny and get a six pack and stuff, all before I think my 18th birthday. Yeah, it didn't happen like that. So joined a gym locally in Trillick for a good few years, and actually that's where I first met Mark Teague, and he introduced me to my first barbell. Then lost the weight, put on the weight, all those kind of things. And then went to college, piled on the weight again, but anyway, got engaged in 2014 and was like, right, need to do something, get married in 11 months time. And Pete Campbell actually put up a post saying that he was looking for, I suppose, new clients. And me and Fiona actually both messaged him, hoping that like one of the two of us would get it. So he messaged me back and I was like, hey, you know, I'm getting married. And then he was like, great, okay, I'd love to take you on. And I was like, but there's kind of one condition, you have to take my bridesmaid too. So Pete was like, I don't generally do like two-on-ones. And anyway, he agreed to it. And yeah, we've been with Pete since 2014.
So you started your journey with Mark and Pete, and you've been with them ever since then?
Yeah, Mark actually said last night I was one of the first to know them, but the last one to join the team at the minute. So
that's right. That's a good way of looking at it. So
yeah,
who's just moving on from that then? What was your first impression of Mark and Pete then? Whenever you started working with them?
Well, I'd only ever done like cardio training and stuff up till I met Mark, and Mark introduced me to the barbell and trying to deadlift and stuff, and I couldn't walk for about a week after it, and I could never say Tabata training, so we used to call it Giabata training. They had too much Giabatas going there. So he introduced me to that. And then Pete, I suppose as Aaron said, Pete was so active on social media, and I was kind of like, what? These hour sessions are going to be crazy, because you know the way Pete came across in his videos. And then I remember going down to him in the first few sessions and being like, Pete's not like anything what he's like in his videos. He was actually, you know, quite mellow and really quiet on it. So yeah, so we did a lot of training for up to the wedding. Yeah, so it's all good.
Yeah, so Pete, the one thing about Pete is he's really professional, I suppose you'd say. So he's really professional in front of the camera, and he plays a certain role. Then as you say, in person he's really laid back, really mellow. Really easy to get along with. So no, that's good then. It's funny, you started your journey with Pete and Mark and you've been with them ever since then. So suppose you've been a member of Source since it opened, haven't you?
Yeah.
Perfect. And that's nearly 3 years now in November.
Yeah, so I came across from when they previously worked in a different gym, then I came across then Source.
Perfect. That was going to be my next question, was how did you come about joining Source? But you've just answered it there. So you just came across along with Pete and Mark when they opened it.
Yeah.
So some people might not know about you then. I'm sure this is probably, you took an influence from Pete and Mark in this as well. But you've actually competed in powerlifting before as well, in a competitive environment. So was it Pete and Mark that got you into that, or was it with Fiona, or how did you get into powerlifting?
I suppose it was trying to get a new goal after the wedding. Me and Fiona, the bride, great bridesmaid that she was, really focused on the wedding. It was all about dieting. It was all about that day, I suppose, and trying to look the best you could for that day. And then afterwards, it was kind of like a real slum. It was like, you know, what do? We were training like 6 days a week, and all we ever focused on was diet and training for the diet, if you know what I mean. So then Pete and Mark recommended that we start, you know, trying to change the focus. So they were starting the powerlifting, so we started as well, and loved it. Loved the training. It was so focused. You weren't worried about diet. You had to like properly eat nutritious food to be able to perform the best way you could and get stronger. So it was a total new focus for us. And yeah, then I only did one competition with it, quite a long block of training beforehand, but it was really good. Did one competition, Pete and Mark, Fiona screaming in the back so I could get the deadlift off the ground.
Yeah.
So it was good.
Is it something that you would recommend to people who are listening that maybe want to take their training to the next level? Is competing in powerlifting something that you would recommend?
Yeah, it's really good. I really enjoyed it. Really like focuses your training, and especially, you know, if you've come from like dieting and things like that, there you just totally forget about all that, and you're not, don't forget about your diet, but you know what I mean, it's not about how many calories you're putting into, you know, whatever, it's about how much weight you can lift on the bar, and you know how precise your training has to be. And no, it was really, really good, and the atmosphere, you know, around it, and that was great as well, the day of the competition days and stuff.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of people focus on diet, they focus on how many calories they're eating, but as you say, if you're getting stronger, you're feeling better within yourself, then that's a lot more important than the number on the scales or how much calories you're eating in your diet. So definitely powerlifting is a good way of, because as you say there, it's a long block of training before you even get to your competition, so you're obviously going to get serious gains from that in terms of strength. Can you remember any of your PBs, what you hit in the powerlifting?
Well, I think my deadlift was like 102.5 with a really wobbly knee coming inwards on the way, and I can really hear Mark Teague's voice, get it up. And I think my bench press was 45. I can't really remember what my squat was. It wouldn't have been my strongest point. Maybe 80 or 85. I'm not just 100% sure. Fiona's probably in the background going, she's bumming them numbers up way too high.
I remember when I started coaching in Source, and I remember training you one time, and you definitely stood out in terms of your technique, and then in terms of your strength as well. I remember saying, I think it was Aaron or Mark maybe, because I didn't know anybody's names really. I was like, that girl there is really solid. I think you were back squatting or something. And Mark was like, yeah, she done powerlifting before. And I was like, yeah, you can definitely see that you've done some form of lifting before. And obviously the work you did with Mark and Pete paid off big time. So the next question then is, in terms of your internship now with Source. So for those who don't know, you're currently on maternity leave now with your role in childcare, after having Molly. And then we've established that you've had a real passion for fitness for the last few years. You've done your powerlifting. How did it come about then, your internship with Source? Is fitness something that you always wanted to get into in terms of coaching others, or because obviously you competed and stuff before? So just how did that come about then, that opportunity?
Yeah, I suppose fitness was always something I was really passionate about, I suppose because I went through the journey myself. About 6 years ago, I did my level 2 fitness instructor, and then I was going to go down that route, but because I had my childcare as well, and then a full-time post came up on it, it just kind of went with that way, you know. I couldn't fit in full-time work, doing the group training and also doing my own training, so I just decided to focus on my own training and, you know, the childcare for now. Then I think I was about 38 weeks pregnant with Molly, and Pete approached me about doing the internship with Source, and I was like, are you serious? I'm about to have a baby here. But it couldn't have came, like looking back now, it couldn't have came at a better time, because you wouldn't have the time working full time with a young family to go and learn something, you know, so new to me. So it just couldn't have came at a better time to have this opportunity now to learn, I suppose, from six of the best people to could learn from in the industry. So it's just, yeah, it's been a great time. So just doing the internship now since about October time. And then really kicked off then in the new year.
Yeah. So I think it was since the new year you've been in about the gym, you've been shadowing the classes, getting a bit of experience from that. And then you've been taking a few of the classes as well. You've been doing a few of the warm-ups, few of the main lifts, few of the conditioning blocks at the end and stuff. What was your feelings when you had to do your first ever warm-up? Or I think it was a warm-up you did first, wasn't it? What was your feelings going into that class, knowing that you had to take control of the session?
Yeah, I, like, working in childcare for years, I had no problem standing up in front of people, you know, delivering presentations, taking staff meetings, things like that. And I went from, like, here to here when I went to open my mouth to speak. I couldn't get my words out. It wasn't actually the hardest bit, because there was only, I think, you know, six or eight people in that class. It was when the conditioning from upstairs joined downstairs and I had to speak to like 12, 13 people, I was like, I couldn't get my words out. Couldn't tell them whether to go right or left or what to do. But you and Aaron just like to throw you in the deep end. And like, I think one of my first CNAMs that I was shadowing, Aaron out of nowhere just says, okay, Michelle's going to take the next set here. And I was like, like, it was all over my face of what I was thinking and miming to him. But yeah, no, it's just good. You just throw in the deep end and just go with it. And as I say, like, I was doing so much learning with use behind the scenes. So yeah, you just get in and get on with it.
That's it. You definitely had the knowledge. It was just, as you say, the confidence. But everyone's like that whenever you introduce someone to a new group of people under new circumstances. We all get kind of nervous. As you say, like, you're used to doing presentations in front of groups in your childcare. You're probably not used to taking a class in a fitness environment, but after a week or so you were absolutely flying. As you say, you're very knowledgeable when it comes to fitness anyway, in terms of you've done your powerlifting, your technique is solid. We've done a lot of work behind the scenes, the theory part as well, with myself, Rachel and Aaron. So you're more than ready. The next question then is, what was your first impression of the team then? For example, your first staff meeting, what were your first impressions of the group? Because I know we've coached you before, you've been a member, but I suppose you might not have known what went on behind the scenes so much. So what was your first impressions of behind the scenes at Source?
I think a lot of you have already touched on this, but like, I was in the first meeting and as you said, my head just went like this. The questions, the ideas, the talk was just flying back and forth and everybody was just like bouncing off each other and everybody knew, everybody was on the same level, same page. Everybody knew what everyone was talking about. And I was sitting going, how am I ever going to, you know, rise to the mark here? But a few meetings in, I was like, yeah, this is something. I really want to be part of this team. This is something I love. I loved how, you know, in some teams, there can be like a hierarchy and, you know, but it's not like that. It's everybody's going in one direction. Everybody's out for the one end goal. It's just great. But I think one of my biggest meetings that kind of stick out to me that I was like, whoa, yeah, I want to do this, was Aaron was standing up the front saying about monumental.
Yeah.
I didn't know what the word even monumental meant then, and I was like, by the end of that meeting I was like, yeah, this is it.
Yeah, that was a good meeting. So just for a bit of clarity on that one, a bit of context for the listeners, we have a certain amount of core values that we try and uphold every time we're working in the gym. One of our core values is always having a monumental mindset. So we don't want to be just the best gym in Oma, for example. We want to be the best gym in the UK. We want to be known as the best gym in the world. And that's just us thinking monumentally all the time. So that was definitely a good meeting that time. I was the same as you. My first ever meeting, I was just kind of like, I was like ping pong. I was just like looking. I wasn't really contributing anything because I was just like, what the hell's going on here? Like, how are these people talking so in-depth about the smallest of things? Like even the last day we had a Zoom meeting and we spoke for an hour about what was the best way to let our members know about Zoom PTs. Was it put the link on Facebook, or was it send it out via email, or was it send it out via WhatsApp? Such a simple thing, but it's something that we wanted to get right and we wanted to make as smooth as possible. So we literally spent an hour talking about what was the best way to inform our members how to access their Zoom PTs. So that just shows you sort of the attention to detail that we try and go into all the time.
Yeah.
So the next question then is, what have you enjoyed most about your time in the internship? Has it been the interaction with the members, or has it been the interaction with the staff, or what has been your most enjoyable thing?
I suppose it's been everything. First of all, yeah, the interaction with members, because when I was, you know, just a member, you kind of had your own slots, and I would have been, you know, seeing the regular people that would have been in those classes. Whereas now, like, I'm exposed to way more members, and it's great to get to know everybody and kind of get to know their journey and be part of their journey. And then I suppose the team, it's such a great team to be around. It's so positive, and that's what I'd say, I suppose, on my personal level, only for the team during lockdown. I haven't really felt like I'm in lockdown. You know, we have so many Zoom calls and all the rest. It's been great, and the positive vibe. Like, I remember Pete, when we were first PT, and it's like, you know, you need to surround your people with people going in the same direction as you, or positive people. And that's definitely what the team and the internship has done for me. So it's been great.
Yeah, 100%. I'm the same as you. So whenever I joined Source, I was kind of like, didn't know what direction I was kind of heading. I was kind of, didn't really have a drive to go in a certain direction. But as you say, whenever you surround yourself with the six other members of staff, in particular, Martin, Pete, because they're so well-driven, you can't help but just get along with that and head in the same direction that they're going, which is always forward and up the ways. So they've definitely had a big impact in the way I look about things as well. So no, that's 100%. I suppose the next question is, what has been your main takeaway from the internship? So what have you learned the most? If there's anything at all that stands out in your head?
I suppose it's the biggest thing is that we're not, like, the Source is not just all about fitness and lifting weights, and, you know, it's surely nothing about, like, you know, calories or anything like that there. It's about, like, being part of people's journey to change their lives and make their quality of life better, and it's such a community. And I think lockdown's really proved that Source is way more than just a gym. You know, it's such a community that nearly wrap around people, and we all go on the journey together. So it's just been a total, like, I think if I'd started maybe this, you know, going down the fitness route in a different gym, it would have been a completely different journey for me. So it's just been so much more than just learning, you know, how to teach someone to do a bench, squat and deadlift. It's been so much more than that, about the whole overall package that's part of Source.
Yeah, 100%, definitely. Great answer. You mentioned there about people's journey. Is that what the part of coaching that you're most passionate about, is helping people along your journey, or what particular part of coaching are you most passionate about?
Yeah, I think I'm like a real people's person, and I love, like, caring for people. I suppose it's the same way as caring for kids. I have a real interest in, like, you know, where someone starts and then how many doors open up for them afterwards. You know, it's not just about what you do in the gym, it's the whole whatever prove quality of life is after this, and but it stems, I suppose, Source, it begins there, and then what comes from it. So that would be, you know, really what I'd be interested in, is the whole kind of holistic journey for the client.
Yeah, perfect. So that's it then in terms of your journey at Source. I think I talk for the rest of the team in saying that you've added a huge amount to the team. You're far more confident now. You're able to put your input into the staff meetings, and it's always valuable. So I'm looking forward to whenever we reopen, seeing you put what you've learned now in lockdown into action and the coaching environment. So I'm really looking forward to that. And then we've got our Friday meetings as well. Me and Michelle have a Friday meeting where we just discuss a certain topic to do with fitness or even to do with Source. And that's always really enjoyable as well. So a couple more questions then before we finish. The next one is, what is your favorite training modality? So what's your favorite thing to train with? Is it a barbell, a kettlebell, a dumbbell, or do you enjoy bodyweight training? Which one is it?
I feel like Rachel Gray's kind of staring through the screen as to what I reply here. I suppose the most experience I would have is with the barbell. But since having Molly, I started the TSC. So I've really enjoyed the kettlebell training. Obviously, Rachel's been a great influencer on that. So I've really enjoyed kind of learning those techniques now. And it's just something completely different because I did barbell for so long. Now the kettlebell is a whole other thing and how you can do so much with this small piece of metal. I'm really enjoying the kettlebells at the minute.
I it's funny how addicted you become to a kettlebell for some reason. I don't know, you don't seem to become as addicted to a barbell, but whenever you start doing kettlebell training, I think it's because it's just so sort of complex and it's a lot faster and you need a certain amount of control with a kettlebell that you don't need with a barbell, because it goes that fast, say for example a swing or a snatch. I remember looking at Mark's Instagram page whenever I started working at Source and it was just all kettlebell stuff and I was like, geez, he mustn't train barbells at all. But whenever I started training kettlebells along with Rachel, I was like, now I know why Mark just trains kettlebells, because it is so addictive. You mentioned there about the TSC. So just in case the members don't know or the listeners don't know, TSC stands for Tactical Strength Challenge. It's a competition that runs in May and October every year. So Michelle, you were going to take part in May there. Unfortunately, it was cancelled due to COVID-19. But fingers crossed, I'm not sure what the circumstances are going to be, but fingers crossed it will happen in October. Is that something that you're really looking forward to, is competing again? Because I know you competed in the powerlifting. Are you looking forward to competing in the TSC?
I suppose I'm like very new to the TSC training. It was only, I suppose Molly was 6 or 8 weeks old whenever I started. So, you know, I still have, you know, a lot of technique that I need to brush up on and that and get that wee bit stronger, but definitely is something that's a totally new focus again. I love like learning new skills. I love kind of being put out of my comfort zone. So I suppose brush up on my skills and my strength, which has been great in lockdown. You know, we've really focused on the TSC and the training with Rachel during it. So yeah, definitely is something I will like to do down the line when, you know, I mean, I wouldn't want to hurry into it or anything or hurry into a competition. So just, you know, whenever, brush up my pull-up skills a little bit more, maybe.
Yeah, you could.
Pull-up bar.
You could use the October competition now to sort of just get a wee bit of experience under your belt. And then next May then is whenever you're going to hit it with a bang then. So the Tactical Strength Challenge, folks, is three different tests. So you've got max bodyweight pull-ups. You've got one RM in your deadlift, which is a one rep max. And then you've got snatch test, so the max amount of snatches that you can do in 5 minutes. Which one of them would you be looking forward to the most, Michelle?
I don't know, probably not the pull-ups, probably your deadlift, probably the deadlift. 5 minutes snatching is a long time. It's hard to keep the hands right, how to stop the hands from ripping when you're doing this kettlebell training.
I know.
Like Rachel told me the other day that instead of going to get my nails filed, I need to go get my calluses filed. So not exactly the most attractive thing.
I know, the kettlebell can be quite unforgiving in the hands. Me and you we're still quite new to the snatching, so God knows how it would fare out on a 5 minute snatch test in October time. We'll give it a go anyway. Hopefully it does take place in October. If it is, I'm looking forward to it, competing with the rest of the gang, because last October I didn't get to take part because I was playing football, I think. So I missed out. And then whenever you see the videos and the pictures, you miss that buzz. You're like, I wish I was there. So now hopefully it takes place in October and then we can, both of us can get to compete in it. Moving away from training then, another wee question is, what has been your favorite thing about lockdown 2020 or quarantine 2020, as Aaron calls it? What's been your favorite thing about it?
I suppose it's just like, I know I was off maternity leave, I was going to be off you know, work anyway, but it's just slowing things down a wee bit. I remember you saying in your podcast that you were like busy, you just filled your life with busyness. I suppose I thought that I was so busy and didn't have time to do this, this and this. So it's just been great to kind of put the brakes on for a wee while and focus on what's important. And like, I never thought I took so much for granted beforehand that I wouldn't be able to sit in my mom and dad's house and have a cup of tea or have my family in the house. Like, so it's, I suppose it's the biggest thing that I've learned is just to slow down and, you know, worry about the, or not worry, but, you know, focus on the most important thing, which was your family and friends around you. And just thankful that nobody so far, touch wood, is sick or anything. So no, it's definitely been, it's been a great opportunity just to slow things down a wee bit. And I hope I don't go back to the, this was the rat race again whenever things open up again. But I will be glad to sit in my mum's dad's house, have a cup of tea, eat a bun or a scone or something, and have everybody else back in my own house too.
Yeah, definitely. You can't, you have to put a positive spin on it, don't you? If you just thought negatively about it, your head would be all over the place. So I suppose the positive,
I've really enjoyed it. I've really, you know, I've kind of thrived in it.
I know, I'm the same. It has been an enjoyable experience. As you say, it just gives you time to put the brakes on, and just sort of think about things a lot more, what's important to you and what's not important to you. So no, that was a great answer. So if you could go back to the start of lockdown, say, and you could share the lockdown experience with three people, and now we'll just include the people that are in your household, so Paul, Cormac and Molly. If you could have, say, two more people along with those, who would you pick and why?
Oh, my answer is probably going to be pretty boring on this one. It would definitely be, well, God, are you making me pick between my parents?
You can have two people.
It would probably be, you know, my parents as well in it, like, because I would have been so close to my mum for this, you know, or obviously so close to my mum. Well, I'll take mommy in, and I suppose Fiona would go mad if I didn't say, that's really bad, I didn't take my mum and dad. I also love my father.
I was hoping you would say your mum and dad, and then I was just going to jump straight in with, what about Fiona? Poor Fiona's left out.
No, Fiona, Fiona kind of comes part and parcel as well, so... take Sheila and Fiona, that's really bad. Daddy can come in too. We have to have three.
I'll give you three. You can take your dad as well. I suppose Fiona could be like a training buddy for you as well. They push you along with a kettlebell training.
Yeah.
So last question then, is one that Pete was asked in his podcast, and he gave a really good answer. Whenever I think back to my answer, I don't think it was a great one, but name three people that inspire you the most in your life,
personal and fitness, or just whatever?
Yeah, more so personal, but in terms of fitness as well, they can be one as well, or two or whatever. Just three people that have sort of inspired you to be the person you are today.
Yeah, I suppose, like, on a personal level, it would be my mom. Mommy's kind of the person that just gets up and gets on with things, and nothing's a bother to her. So, you know, you could ask her anything and she's like, yep, okay, she'll make it work. You know, doesn't matter what she's got going on in her own space or whatever. So I suppose her, and nothing's a bother to her. I probably wouldn't be able to do all the things to do or the time to do the internship without her, because she helped me out so much with Molly and Cormac. And I have to say Paul there as well, because he's, you know, the same way. I couldn't have done this internship either. I couldn't have done really anything I've done so far without his support, and it's really hard working as well. So just, you know, the drive kind of going forward and wanting the best for our family, and that was comes from him. And then on a fitness level, I also don't have a big high fluting Instagrammer like you really influences me. It has to be like the Source team, it really does. I suppose Pete was my PT for so long. He really does put things in perspective that, you know, stop chasing this perfect body within fitness, you know, or whatever. You're not going to be happy with a six pack and 5% body fat. You know, your life's worth so much more than that. So Pete used to always talk about, I don't know how much he's going to appreciate me saying this or not, but like, shit's in a bucket. And like, you know, dump out the shits that you don't need in your life and keep the ones you do. So I suppose like that, even at that simple statement, has helped me so much. So yeah, the Source team, but I suppose especially Pete, because started the journey with him.
So we've got Sheila, we've got Paul, and we've got Pete.
And the whole Source team.
And the whole Source team. Good stuff. Pete's a great man for the metaphors, but yeah. I don't think I've ever heard him say that one before. Shit's in a bucket. So hopefully he can explain that one in the next staff meeting. That was the question I was going to ask you. We were speaking beforehand, was what page do you like to follow the most on Instagram? What's your favorite page? But you said that you're not big into your social media. So I went with who inspires you the most, and it was a far better question anyway. So good stuff, Michelle. That brings us to the end of the podcast. It's been great chatting to you. I've loved hearing things about you that I didn't know, like the fact that you're premature and stuff like that. So I hope you've enjoyed it. Really looking forward to having you as part of the team whenever we get back into the full swing of things post COVID-19. I'm sure you're looking forward to it as well. And I say the members are definitely looking forward to being coached by you as well. Is there anything you want to say before you go?
No, thank you. Thanks for it.
You said you were nervous beforehand, but you definitely didn't let the nerves show there. You were brilliant. So well done.
No, you put me at ease. You put me right at ease.
Good stuff. So folks, that's it for this episode of SOURCECAST with the newest member of the team, Michelle McGrenaghan. I hope you're all looking forward to being coached by Michelle at some stage. We'll have a new episode next week. We're not sure what the topic is going to be, but this is going to be a weekly thing anyway. So that's the 7 members of staff that have all done their podcast. So I hope you've enjoyed listening to the Meet the Team series. And then from next week on, we're going to have a new series, and we'll let you know in due course what the topic is going to be. Thanks very much for tuning in, folks. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.